Tell us where we are.
Miami.
We're going to the beach. We've just pulled up at the hotel. The drive was a nightmare, but we're here now and we're going to go swimming. We're going to look out for sharks. Hopefully all will go well.
Having spent 2 weeks straight roaming the streets of Orlando at the mercy of our driving family members, it was finally time to leave the city limits and explore the greater state of Florida. Being one of the four iconic corner cities in the US, Miami was the perfect choice for such a grand excursion. From its famous beaches to its neon-lit buildings, we knew this would make for a fantastic family outing. So as the sun rose that Wednesday morning, we packed our bags and climbed aboard a 2017 Toyota Camry for a trip to the Magic City. And it all began with a nutritious, blue-flavored slushie from a classy gas station by the I-4.
Alrighty, so we made it to Miami Beach. It's a pretty nice beach. It's pretty standard, but it's a very big beach. It was like a massive cargo ship blocking the view a minute ago, but it's passed now, it's all good. There was a little hint of rain, but I think we'll be okay. We're gonna take a dip in the ocean. Hopefully there aren't any sharks.
Our afternoon at the beach was an all-round classic, free of sharks and lightning strikes. But as the sun began to fall, we retreated from the seafront and began to search for an evening meal.
Okay, we got back from the beach, we were in the hotel for a while, and now we're going to dinner. We're all really happy.
I take it back, read it.
Okay, so it's the evening now,
we came back from the beach,
and we stayed in the hotel for a while, but now,
I don't like this angle, it's okay.
Whatever. We've made it to the Española Way. It's like a famous Spanish sort of street, like Caribbean. It's really cool. I think we'll find something to eat here.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
How is it, Rachel?
It was really lovely, thank you.
Was it? Describe it more. Describe it more.
Well, we aren't sure if it's key lime pie or a passion fruit tea.
It's green, which makes me think that it's actually lime. Key lime.
Great analysis. So that was a pretty decent meal. I think we all enjoyed it, but it was quite expensive. Luckily, I didn't pay. So I think we're just gonna have another walk around now. I think we're gonna get ice cream and then head back to the hotel for tomorrow. But it's quite nice and it's still warm, which is lovely. Oh, all these Spanish restaurants, Italian flags, it's like we're being back in Europe.
Japanese.
Yeah, the Japanese one's a bit out of place, but still welcome, I suppose. Thought I'd showcase this little shop that we stopped by. They play very loud Spanish music and they sell genuine alligator heads, which I think is quite disturbing, but in a good way. Who wouldn't want one of these? Bit of a showcase.
Hello.
Oh god. So we're back in the hotel room and our room has this view of the restaurant.
Joshua, what if they own guns?
Okay, we're out on the town for the last time tonight. Heading back to the hotel now. It has been a riveting day in Miami, despite the 4-hour drive, most of which being stuck in traffic. First impressions to see. Nice city. I quite like it. Hopefully we'll be more lucky with some of the weather tomorrow, although the sun is quite damaging, so maybe not. Don't know what we're gonna do. It was like a museum or something that we might have had planned, but yeah, we don't plan anything around here, so we'll see.
Strolling up and down Ocean Drive, we witnessed the world-famous Miami Lights and basked in their many variations of pink and blue. But after an unfortunate loss of blueberries, we returned to the hotel where the day drew to a close. It was an excellent introduction to the city, and there was still so much more to see tomorrow. So we finished off the day with some motivational snoring from the stranger down the hall before tucking ourselves into bed.
Okay, so it's day two in Miami, and we're ready for a frantic getaway, because checkout time is in 20 minutes, and people are still getting ready, there's lots of stuff everywhere, so we might be charged.
I just got out of the closet.
Haha. What about you, son?
I just put Vaseline on.
Good one. Okay, day two. Back on the streets of Miami. Turns out we're not really going to stay around for that long. I'm not in control of anything here, but me and the Hannah are going to Raising Cane's, which we heard is quite a nice restaurant that they have around the US, especially their sauce. So we're going to give that a go. We're going to buy the entire menu and shovel it down the gob before leaving for a shopping mall of all things, something that we could go to anywhere. So that's fun, that's good.
And so we trekked across the Miami sidewalks once more towards the TikTok chicken shop for yet another nourishing breakfast. Upon arrival, we raced through the ordering process before meeting Post Malone and collecting our meals. Shortly after, we were pacing up the street back to the hotel, and within 5 minutes, we were driving west to Dolphin Mall.
Okay, so we sailed over here in a car. This is Dolphin Mall on the outskirts of Miami, and it's quite nice actually. We devoured our Raising Cane's, it was basically our breakfast. And yeah, so it was pretty good. My main critique was that without the sauce, everything was just a bit so like average. But no, it was good overall. Would recommend, and it was a good price too. Right now, we're trying to find the rest of our group, but I think we went the wrong way. So we've done it the long way, and I think we're getting even further now. Oh dear.
The mall experience was a blur of generic shopping and lack of windows. After 4 hours of being inside, the rain started to pick up and we began our escape down the I-75. Three and a half hours on the road rattled away with the sound of I Spy and Subway Surfers filling the air. Our arrival in Tampa marked the end of a successful yet short trip to the Magic City.
Visit! Woo!
And the start of our final week in the Sunshine State. As one trip began to reach its conclusion, the next one was on the horizon, so we looked ahead to the future, to a new country. But in the meantime, we settled into the Big Guava, where a new makeup artist waited for me.